NDTV learns that guidelines for new bank licenses are likely to be out in the next couple of weeks. NDTV has learned that there's a good chance that Indian promoters of new banks will be allowed to hold up to 40% equity for a start, with a provision to scale down eventually. Sapna Das has more.
The Indian banking space is preparing for some more players. And this time again, it's the Indian promoters themselves who could very well be the single largest holder in the bank. The RBI, in consultation with the government, is keen to maintain the Indian promoters' shareholding at 40%, with a clause to dilute stake in stages. For instance, the stake can be diluted to 20% over a period of time. Even now, under exceptional circumstances, promoters in private sector banks can hold up to 30% with the approval of the RBI. Whereas, under normal circumstances, RBI does not allow any single individual or entity to own and control shares in excess of 10%. On the other hand, shareholding of non-residents could be capped at 5%, while other resident shareholders will be allowed up to 10%. Shareholders will need RBI's nod to exceed these caps. However, as always, there will be caveats. The Reserve Bank will exercise regulatory and supervisory powers over holding companies of the new banks. It will have the right to call for information, examine financial records of these companies, as well as have the power to supersede the boards.
So while it's good news for industrial houses looking to set up banks, RBI's additional regulatory and supervisory powers, including the lifting of the 10% cap on voting rights, all of this rests in the new Banking Laws Amendment Bill, which has just got tabled in the Parliament in the last budget session. Till this crucial bill gets the Parliament's nod, the new bank license policy will not be able to take off on the ground. In New Delhi, Sapna Das, NDTV.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone. Fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.